We are continuing our series looking into how COVID-19 is affecting our kids. And today we're exploring children and the vaccine.
In just over a week, Australian teenagers will be eligible for the jab. But when will it be safe for young children and how vulnerable are they until then? Today's Ashlyn Krukellis reports.
As our race to vaccinate the nation ramps up, those able to receive the jab are getting younger. Almost a week ago, the Pfizer jab was approved for Australians as young as 12, and it couldn't come soon enough for the Neville family in the Sydney suburb of Kingsford.
Yes, I do believe it's taken too long for us to get to this point.
12-year-old Catherine and 15-year-old Daniel will be among those booking in from September 13th.
I would love to get the vaccine if it would help.
I'll be able to play with all my mates again.
Soon as we can, we're out there rolling up the sleeves.
Year 12 students are a priority, especially in the lockdown states of New South Wales and Victoria.
We both wanted to get it straight away because most of our family anyway has been vaccinated.
Initially, I didn't want to get vaccinated. And then seeing the severity of the Delta variant, I said to my mum, you know, I want to be vaccinated.
Now that many have received their first dose, we're learning more about side effects in young people.
Who had a sore arm after getting the vaccine?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, 100%.
Who had further side effects?
I had pain into my chest.
Yeah, like Ella, I was a bit anxious after the vaccine.
We are seeing in a very small subgroup of particularly the young males, we are seeing that a small proportion of them are getting this inflammation of the lining of the heart or of the heart muscle itself. Whilst it's concerning, it's actually proving to be not very, very severe.
But what about young children? When will it be considered safe for them to be vaccinated against COVID-19? And how do parents feel about their little ones getting the jab?
As long as it's safe and effective, I'd be totally for it.
I think, you know, if we can do everything we can to keep them safe and keep all our little ones safe, I think it's the best way forward.
Winnie, do you want to get a COVID vaccination?
No!
I think there's a reason to question it, and I don't blame people and parents for wanting more information.
We can expect more information in around 6 weeks as trials finish in America. 4,500 children aged between 6 months and 12 years are currently testing the Pfizer vaccine. Moderna is running a similar trial.
From there, the data is then sent to the TGA and they make their decision. So I would expect, without putting a definite number on it, that sort of within the next 6 months or so, we would likely see approvals for a vaccine down either to 5 years or even potentially down to 6 months of age.
When it comes to young children, are they likely to have the same dose as an adult or a smaller dose?
They're working out at the moment in different age brackets exactly what the right dose is. So it's all part of the clinical trials. And so when they report their findings, it'll report sort of whatever they found was the most effective, the safest, and had sort of the least side effects.
Until then, children remain vulnerable, with the Doherty Institute warning COVID could claim the lives of up to 86 children if the country opens up with no restrictions with 70% vaccinated.
We are going to have to look at this issue of opening up not as a open or close, but as a gradually loosening of restrictions.
So it's up to those who are eligible to roll up their sleeves to protect our kids and help pave the way towards normal life.
Who misses going to school?
100%.
Never thought I'd say this.
Yeah.
I'm very keen to get the certificate to show that everyone fully vaccinated.
I think it's definitely a step forward and a step in the right direction too.
The human touch is quite powerful, and that's what I want for all of us.
It's a great statement, that, isn't it? 100% right. Tomorrow, to mark the final day of our Kids and COVID series, child psychologist Dr. Justin Coulson and paediatrician Professor Margie Danchin will join us live to answer all of your questions. So you might have some, send them to us right there on that email site, today@nine.com.au. Take part, send in those questions and we'll get them to you tomorrow on the show. It's been a really interesting week of those stories.
Series, that, isn't it?
People have really enjoyed it at home.
Important questions that have been answered.